And could a political working formula between opposition leader Raila Odinga and former presidential candidate Peter Kenneth be in the offing? Well, apart from the pact that the two politicians have had for more than three separate meetings this year, legislators from the opposition have been piling pressure on Peter Kenneth to agree and deputize Raila Odinga in their 2022 general election. But as our senior political affairs reporter Chris Thierry reports in this week's House of Cards, Peter Kenneth still faces the challenge of convincing the Mount Kenya leadership why he is fit to succeed President Kenyatta as the region's political kingpin.
A 53-year-old and a former presidential candidate in the 2013 general election, Peter Kenneth has been touted as one of the possible successors of President Uhuru Kenyatta as the Mount Kenya political kingpin after Uhuru retires from active politics. However, since he left his political office in 2013 as the Gatanga Member of Parliament, all his political calculations have flopped. In the March 2013 general election, he ran for the presidency but failed, coming in fourth with 72,000 votes. He would later go silent for 4 years, only to resurface in 2017 with the intention to succeed Evans Kidero, who was then the Nairobi County Governor, but then again failed. With 4 years to the 2022 general polls, Peter Kenneth has gone back to the drawing board. For months now, he has on several occasions held meetings with opposition chief Raila Odinga, raising suspicion of a possible working political alliance ahead of the 2022 polls.
The pressure that has been piled on Peter Kenneth to work with Raila Odinga, I think it is timely because the two come from a background of very good performance in terms of reforms, in terms of democracy, in terms of decent leadership that this country has been yearning for. So their chemistry in terms of political leadership is there.
Apart from accompanying the ODM party leader to London to watch the Gor Mahia versus Everton game at Goodison Park, Kenneth mid this year visited Raila at his Capitol Hill office, where they held lengthy talks. And only last weekend, Kenneth had been invited by politicians affiliated to NASA as a chief guest in a fundraising in Saboti, Trans-Nzoia County. Could Peter Kenneth be warming up to deputize Raila Odinga in the 2022 polls?
He needs Raila because there's every chance that Raila might exit politics. So Luo Nyanza is normally a consolidated voting block, and whoever Raila Odinga will support or will indicate will have serious say and influence. And that is why you've seen the Gideon Moyes going now to Luo Nyanza, you've seen Peter Kenneth. And for me, that is a stronger coalition that will work for him than even Peter Kenneth and Ruto.
You can see from his names, he does not carry the tribal baggage, Peter Kenneth. You know, those are names that have no tribal linings. And therefore, he's a candidate, if he vies for the president of this country, he's a candidate that appeals to all Kenyans across the board.
The relationship between Peter Kenneth and Deputy President William Ruto has not been rosy since the 2017 Jubilee nominations, where Peter Kenneth lost to Mike Sonko for the Nairobi gubernatorial ticket. PK, as his close friends refer to him, would later join the Kenya Alliance of Independent Candidates as an alliance of candidates who lost the Jubilee ticket and accused Deputy President William Ruto of shortchanging them.
For him to be anything within the political circles in 2022, he must come out as the de facto leader of Mount Kenya region. He must get that support. And if he gets that support, there is every possibility. Whether he is going to be in the ballot as a presidential candidate or as a running mate, or he will be the kingmaker, he will have a lot of influence. And going forward, he can be able to negotiate for the position, whatever positions his people in terms of Mount Kenya region will want to have.
This country does not love people who are fence-sitting. This country wants people who are decisive. When there is a decision to be made, come out be it negative, be it positive, make a stand, be known. And I think of late you've seen him. We've talked about the VAT. He's spoken about the handshake.
According to his close political associates, Peter Kenneth has been treading carefully not to antagonize President Uhuru Kenyatta and has embraced the handshake as he supports the Jubilee agenda, hoping that the president will endorse him as his successor as the Mount Kenya political kingpin.
Now, apart from Peter Kenneth, other politicians from Mount Kenya region and who have been touted as possible successors to President Uhuru Kenyatta when he retires from active politics include former Kiambu governor William Kabogo, former 2013 presidential candidate Martha Karua, Kirinyaga governor Anne Waiguru, as well as Agriculture Cabinet Secretary Mwangi Kiunjuri. Well, who among them will succeed President Uhuru Kenyatta?
Since Kenneth has expressed that intention, he has even vowed to become the president. Why do I support him? Yes. I'm not aware of any other leader of his caliber.
Our son anaitwa Peter Kenneth. Mnafikiria tumekuja tu hivyo hivyo? Si tumevuta aerio.
Mnajua dalili ya mvua ni nini? Sini mawingu.
The ODM party leader has on several occasions met politicians, both those in office and those out in the cold from the Mount Kenya region, including Kirinyaga Governor Anne Waiguru, former Kiambu Governor William Kabogo, as well as former legislators who failed to clinch the Jubilee ticket or lost in the 2017 polls, a clear indication that Raila has political interest in the region. Chris Dairu, KTN News.